They did not
call. Hear ye, hear ye! I now call to order this meeting of No Man, National Organization of Men Against Amazonian Masterhood.
Institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary. Try, try, try to separate them. It's an illusion. Try, 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 and you will only come to this conclusion, love and marriage.
Wait a second, I can't name this thing. Hold on, there we go. All right, this is day one.
Let's talk about the amazing straddle victory by the Fredericton Fury over the Madoc Turkey Vultures.
It was f***ing charity.
4-3, was it Mikko Rantanen?
Was it Rantanen? I don't know, it was Rantanen.
Mikko Rantanen. Just laid it on you.
You know what laid it on me? For three periods, I didn't see the puck. All right, forget the gloss in my eye over here. This is about the Cottage weekend with the boys who I've been friends with for seriously 40-plus years. Some of them are family by blood. Some of them are just family because we choose to be. And as you can see, the weekend starts off with trash talking and will probably end with trash talking. So sit back and have an espresso and join us for the ride on the Boyz weekend away. I suppose the first thing I should do is explain Strat-O-Matic hockey that was mentioned earlier. It's a board game that we've been playing since high school. We're in an organized league and we're highly competitive. It's a game based on the NHL actual results, and here's how it sounds.
He scores!
And there we go! And just like that, Quebec beats Sicily in overtime. So, you're the GM of your own team, and yes, we have a little cup that you win at the end of the season.
Nerds! Nerds! Nerds!
Come on, Lewis, let's go.
Nerds! 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 Nerds!
Yeah, that's right. By my generation standards, we're nerds. Anyways, as you can see, like in most sports, it brings such joy to the winner and such misery to the loser. Mike is visibly upset, but saying nothing.
You're a good brother, bud.
Biting the bullet.
Yeah. Don't stop bleeding.
And the hands have been shaken.
One day you'll get that cut, Mike. Don't stop bleeding.
And then along comes Moses with his words of wisdom. I mean, really, he looks like Moses. Look at him rock that beard.
Woe unto thee, O Israel! You have sinned a great sin in the sight of God.
Truly, this game brings out the worst in us.
Meant to play.
I'm not f***ing angry.
You're on Facebook.
Is that your team? No, still, it's all about the competition. You got to do well for your brothers, the warlord.
That's it. Well,
I know. Rich, when you look in the mirror, what do you find?
And he goes,
I know, sorry.
While others suffer with really bad luck, some can get all the luck and still never be satisfied. Somehow, Frank is complaining.
I don't know. After, I thought it was...
after getting every card, scoring every goal, he's winning. And somehow, all is not right with the world.
Great team. 2-4, that's not very good.
2-1-6?
17.
Face off, face off, face off, face off, wait!
7.
Left wing.
GPS.
Is it 113?
Yeah.
13.
We are the champions, my friend.
Free. The Carla curse is over.
Wow.
The new millennium has begun.
It's too late to apologize.
Fredericton Fury, caught on camera complaining himself to victory. What do you have to say for yourself? Yeah, this game can bring out the worst in people. It brings the best and the worst in emotions. Actually, have a watch and you'll see what exactly what I mean.
So it can happen.
Fuck off. It's fucking game.
That's fucking hilarious. He played all his fours, he's got six power plays. We're in overtime now.
Yeah.
He's on his seventh. And because he played everyone on the point, then there's no centerman because it's 4-on-3.
What the f*** are you going to do now? What are you going to do, snapper?
He's fucking pissed. I got to put the fence on. Pieces of shit, the fence. I even put I follow the other f***. Oh, I got Sorelli on the line.
Is it me, or is Sicily seem the one that always be taking a beating and looking the most miserable? Only one thing to say about that.
Man. You are one pathetic loser.
Okay, enough of that. On to some more important things, like dough rising for pizza night. That's how it starts. Now spread on the pizza pan. Two wonderfully cooked pizza. Now most of us are of Italian blood, and what would a cottage weekend be without a little game of bocce on the beach? Of course, some of us are better at this game than others.
Ooh, out of bounds.
And when you're drinking as much as we're drinking, let anywhere be your toilet. All right, on to other drunken activities, like poker night. Now, our poker night is unlike any other. There's no Texas Hold'em, and there's no serious play. In fact, we play with invisible hands on top of the people at the table. So in other words, a person that's not even there can win the hand. Just have a listen on how we do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, in our Poco Nights, we're playing a game called Larry, Curly, and Moe.
Curly, Larry, and Moe.
Where there are three invisible hands.
They're not invisible, Frank. They're quite real.
So not only are we playing against each other to win the money, but we're playing against invisible opponents as well. And oh, do we take great pleasure when that happens and they beat one of our friends.
A club and it all stays in.
Yeah!
Oh my god! This is brutal. Huh?
Baby. Come on, baby.
Let's go back to this one now. Let's f*** Steve, okay?
Yes.
I have two small pair. Eights and eights.
Oh no.
Eight, two, or Jack.
Eight, two, or Jack.
The other Joker?
Or the Joker.
Yeah!
Four eights!
Yeah!
Four eights!
What the
fuck? Oh, okay.
You.
That's such f***ing horseshit.
Anybody named Frank tonight's an asshole.
I hate them. Unreal.
Now
the dumb guys are
eating. Look how f***ing happy he is, eh? You fucking
shut up. Look at this mountain you got here. Mount Rush.
Yeah, we're pretty juvenile for middle-aged men, but you only live once, and it's a hell of a lot of fun. Now, back to cooking.
There's nine guys, but we have 87 burgers.
Yes. And don't forget the double fried russet potatoes.
How many idiots does it take to cook spinucci? I count 1, 2, 3. Here comes number 4.
And what's a boys' weekend away without a movie with appropriate male bravado?
Yes! We haven't eaten enough meat this weekend, boys. Because we know we're gonna be up late. All
right.
But if you're worried about the weather, then you picked the wrong place to stay.
Delicious.
You're probably thinking, why are we going back to playing this game that makes most of us so miserable? It's a great question, but yet, we do it.
Which Juritano's more miserable, this one?
No, definitely no. Me. I got bile already to come out of my stomach.
Or this Juritano.
Fred, 11 periods, not
a
clue.
You want to zoom in on the chair?
Yeah, here, let's go to the...
What happened to...
This is what happens when... You let it let go. Go back. Quebec's disciplinary system is quite harsh.
Peter Mrazek is on the 60 AIL right now.
And by the way, he's on the trade block if you have Scotch.
Hey, don't worry. No straddle cards were permanently harmed in the making of this video. It is now Sunday. And what does that mean? Well, that means it's time for a good old-fashioned Italian pranzo, and that's pasta with sugo. And there's a lot going on with this sauce. There's sausages in there fresh, there's sausages in there dried, there's also meat from the leftover pork that we had from the soppressata and the salsiccia that we made in January.
Thank him on that one. I just
Sunday boiled... pranzo. Kim, thank you very much.
I just boiled the water, that's it. She did the sauce.
Amazing, amazing concoction. Thank you very much.
It's with the leftover meat from the soppressata and a cup of cola and salsiccia.
Delicious, just delicious.
There's more, eh?
This look is the best compliment you can give a chef. This brings us to the end of the cottage trip, and I've already shown you far too much. All I can tell you is that we've revived the No Mams Club for one reason and one reason alone.
I'm married with children.
Ah, come on. You know we love you, ladies. It's just that we've been friends for way too long. And that is something you're just gonna have to deal with.
Love and marriage.